Welcome to Deerhunter.net. Deerhunter.net has been put together, right, as you'll find through a variety of these video reviews, to bring you what has proven to be, in my opinion, the best hunting clothing on the market. Just a little bit about me. I've been hunting, shooting, fishing, right, when we say shooting, we're talking four bore, small bore, shotguns, air rifles, for the best part of coming up 40 years, and over that 40 year period I've tried just about anything and everything when it comes down to outdoor clothing, which is good enough to give you the protection that you need while you're out in all elements. Now, we all have love-hate relationships with wax, cotton and so forth, and over the years I've probably tried just about every major and minor brand name there is on the market. Now, I come across Deerhunter. I've done a lot of product reviews in the past, stemming back some 13 years. And as part of my shooting hobby, I've come across Deerhunter and Deerhunter.net, who at the end of the day are bringing pretty much the whole range to the internet. Now, we thought as we'd look through the range, right, that some of these were really, really worthy of taking out, trying and testing. Now, this isn't just straight out of the packet. Anything you see on these videos is not straight out of the packet and straight in front of the camera. It's been tried, tested in all weathers, it's been washed, dried, and at the end of the day, this is what you see in front of you. Well, let's get started with this. Let's not guess too much about the ins and outs. This is the Recon jacket with reinforcement. Now, everything that you're going to see here, right, is like I say, it's all tried and tested. And one thing that really stands out amongst all of it is the fabric that it's made from. Now, when it comes down to fabrics, the one thing that us shooters want, even bird watchers and so forth, you want something that's quiet. Right? You want something ideally that's silent. Now, the Deerhunter actually bring you a fabric here that is very, very silent, right? It's I'm not gonna say 100% because one of you is bound to get something that make a noise, right? But it is very silent. It's a very comfortable sort of brushed nylon effect. It's not brushed nylon, I don't know exactly what it is, but what I do know is that it does do the job. It's a very comfortable, it's warm to the touch. So anything that you pick up is not just picking up a freezing clammy jacket that you've had in the back of your Land Rover for the last couple of weeks since you last went out. This is always been the same. It's nice. The jacket itself, the stitching is good. The press studs, right, they're brilliant. They're all oversized. They work well. They really do hold very, very nicely. The zippers are YKK. Right, now, in my opinion, I've done a lot of clothing reviews, right, for various companies. There's zippers and there's zippers, and YKK, they make the best. And I've not had one, I shouldn't say this, I'm tempting fate here. I've not had one fail on me yet. Everything's taken into consideration that you're probably going to be working with gloved hands. So nice big tags on those zippers. I mean, look at the size of that. Right, you'll never, ever miss that. Double-ended zipper on the main zip down the front of the jacket. The jacket obviously has the storm flap over the front, so it doesn't need a waterproof zip. But when you come away from that, you start looking at the hand warmer pockets. They are proper waterproof zippers. Just do that up and bring that up closer to the camera. And they really are waterproof. I have had this out in some horrendous weather, and my nice new phone was sat in my pocket and I got a little bit fractious wondering whether it was going to survive the journey, and yes it did. But you've got a whole variety of pockets. Deerhunter have really gone and spoken with a lot of people when they've designed this. You've got the front thigh pockets down here. Now they're huge, like more than enough room in there. They're gusseted as well, together with a drain hole in the bottom, right? But you'll easily get a box of 25 shotgun cartridges in each pocket. So there's no worries about running out of room. You've got tags which come out from the hand warmer pockets, which I'm sure you're quite familiar with this type of design. It's there to hold the pocket flap up, so you've got ease of access to the pockets. And those tags tuck nicely away in the hand warmer pockets when you're not using them. You've got, I'm not sure what this is actually for, it's elasticated, I wonder whether this is for tucking bullets into. I'm not actually sure, I couldn't find that bit out. But if it is, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You'd easily get a 12 gauge shotgun cartridge in that elastic pocket. So maybe that's what it's for. Right, if anybody actually knows, drop me a line and let me know. Moving away from the hand warmer pockets and the front thigh pockets, you move up to, you have a chest pocket here. Now that is more than big enough to get the biggest of smartphones in, if that's what you want to carry there. And up on the left shoulder, we have another pocket here, which is a radio pocket. Now, more and more shoots that we attend, organised shoots, including when I shoot with my son, right, we are always in radio contact. It's just a safety issue, right, especially with the rifle shooting. Very, very important. You obviously know where each other is, right? So at the end of the day, radio contact. And to have a dedicated pocket for that, tucked away on top of the left shoulder, absolutely perfect. Upper arm on each sleeve. Again, waterproof zippers. We have another pocket with, I'm not going to start wrapping them around, but orange safety flashes. A lot of you know, if you're watching this outside of the UK, that you have to have orange clothing when you're shooting, but you've got that on both sleeves. Moving away from the general construction of the jacket, you've got the reinforcement. Now this really is very, very tough material, and again it's silent, right? It's not where there's been any expense spared when it's come down to actually putting this together. Right, the reinforcement on both arms, right the way down the backs of the arms, up where your recoil pad's going to go, and over the shoulder, and across the yoke at the top. So all those hardware areas, rifle slings, bag slings and so forth, you've got that protection there just where you need it. We have a concealed hood in the collar. Right, it's a lightweight hood, but it rolls away quite nicely, and it is waterproof, and I can guarantee you that. I found that out the other day, it came in very handy. There it is. Right, and you've got a cinch down tie there as well. I'll just very quickly just wrap that up and tuck that away. That's the other good thing. I mean, I've done some jackets before in the past where they have a full blown matched hood tucked away. It's okay if you want to take it out and leave it out, or put it away and leave it away. It's quite good for that, but it's when you want to start putting it away and getting it out when you're actually out and about. That's when it can become a little bit of a chore. The cuffs, you've got great big openings there. I've got big hands, never had a problem with it, but you've got a rubberized tag there together with nylon closure, and you can cinch these right down nicely around your wrist to keep that wonderful bad weather out that we come across. Just flip it over. Sorry. You've got, you probably see it a bit easier here, you've got a waist and a bottom hem drawstring, right, to actually tighten it down to keep the wind out. Right, we've got a big full size, and I mean this is this big game pocket across the back there. I personally don't use those, friends of mine do. I prefer a bag, right? It depends on what you're doing and where you're shooting, and just personal preference. We come around to the inside. Now, what I will say with this is that this is a mesh lining, right? The whole jacket, and you'll find a, I'm going to say 99% of Deerhunter clothing has got what they call a Deertex membrane. So now, if you're not familiar with Deertex, but you are familiar with Gore-Tex, think Gore-Tex, does the same job. I have some top-end Gore-Tex jackets that cost twice the price of this. This jacket is as breathable, in my opinion, as those top-end Gore-Tex jackets. It's also as waterproof. This jacket has never leaked, right? So just bear that in mind. I'm not going to lie to you. If it was a pile of junk, I'd tell you it was a pile of junk. It's not. It's quite the opposite. Right, with this drop liner, it's a nice mesh to obviously allow the breathability in the jacket, and that continues down inside the sleeves as well. It really does give you a lot of benefit. I've been shooting in this, a vast majority of my shooting is nighttime. I was out with my son not that long ago. It was about 4 or 5 degrees in the evening, and all I had was a polo shirt on. And I put this jacket on over the top, and it was the coldest weather we'd had it out in at that point, and I thought, well, I'm going to freeze. I didn't. I was actually remarkably warm. Not overheating, but quite warm. I've had it out in the daytime, and it's been in the sort of like the low 20s, 22, 23 degrees Celsius, and it's very cool and breathable. So I'm sure this is a mixture of the fabrics working for you here. I think if you're going to go much colder than what I was out the other night, you probably want to think maybe you want the coat that little bit bigger than normal, right, so you can get a jumper or two underneath it. Sorry. But it does give a great deal of flexibility and range of use to the whole garment. Inside pockets, nice and big, right? Get the hand right inside that. Both of you got one each side, right? They both zip up. Actually, you're not going to lose your possessions or what have you in there. Right, we've got shock cord locks on the waist and the bottom hem pull adjustment on there. Right, all in all, brilliant. Now, one thing that you're all going to be interested in, for those of you that actually wash your shooting clothing, and I know a lot of people that don't, right, it washes very well. 30 degree wash, let the room dry, out on the washing line, can't tumble dry it, but that's no real problem. I've had blood on it. It washes out with no problem at all with normal washing detergents. There's nothing special that's needed for it. I say it dries well. It doesn't need to be ironed. Just have a quick look because, yeah, no, it says do not iron it, which doesn't surprise me with the finish of the fabric, but it doesn't need it. That's the thing. Like, once you've actually got that washed and dried, it's just as it is here. Sorry. At the end of the video, right, you'll find deerhunter.net's web address. If you want to know more information, go on the website. Right, one thing I will say, when you get round to ordering, one thing that we noticed when we was ordering this clothing for testing is that the sizes that you get with Deerhunter don't necessarily exactly match up with what you or I would expect them to. So a little bit of advice from deerhunter.net, and I think it's sound advice. When you come around to ordering, in the information on the ordering information box at the bottom of the page, put in there the exact chest size that you want. Inches or centimetres doesn't matter, right? I'm sure they're capable of working in both. But when it comes down to it, please put that in. It will avoid any disappointment turning up at your front door, and it saves all that messing about sending it back, waiting for a replacement and so on. Please subscribe to the channel. Right, I know it might sound a little bit corny. There's more videos to come on this equipment. And at the end of the day, right, if you subscribe, you will get the updates coming through to your subscription list down the left side of your screens as and when they're published. If you've got any questions, please, please, please drop me a line. I say that, and I really expressly say that. Don't sit there wondering. I don't mind answering your questions. If at the end of the day I don't know the answer, I'll find someone that does. But what I do promise you is you will get the correct answer. I'd like to thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Any questions, drop me a line. Thanks. Bye-bye.